Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for August the 28th of 2019, well, it is titled Messier 61 Close Up. So what do we see here? Well, this is an example of a spiral galaxy, and in fact, a specific type of galaxy called a barred spiral, very similar to what our own Milky Way is. Now, spiral galaxies all have distinct spiral arms coming out from the center. But there is also a version called a barred spiral, which appears to have a bar of material, a bar of stars through the center as well. So our own Milky Way is one of those, and this is another example of that. Now we also see within a spiral galaxy a number of other distinctive features, including bright blue stars. Now it's not that the galaxy is only made up of blue stars, there are lots of other stars there too. But those very hot blue stars are among the brightest ones, and that's why they stand out. We also know that they do not live for a very long time. So because these stars don't live very long, the fact that we're still seeing them means that they must have formed relatively recently. Now we speak about that in an astronomical time frame, meaning that they must have formed within the last few million years, because many of those hottest blue stars could only live a couple of million years. So again, since we see the combined light from all those stars, we know therefore that they must have formed recently. Had these stars formed a billion years ago, they would no longer exist. They would have gone through their lives and would be gone. Now we also see the pink color there. The pink color is also associated with star formation. And that is the hydrogen gas around those young stars being excited by them. So those are both signs that star formation has occurred recently and something that we see in spiral galaxies. Other types of galaxies, such as the elliptical galaxies, do not show these same features and have not had star formation recently. Now, this galaxy is in the nearby Virgo cluster about 55 million light years away. Now, what that means is that we then see this galaxy as it was 55 million years ago. So what does it look like now? Well, we don't know, but we'd say it looks pretty much like it does. Certainly in 55 million years, some of those blue stars have come and gone, and there have been probably a number of supernovae that we simply do not know about yet because there has not been time for the light to get to us. So there have been some slight changes, but overall we could expect that the structure of the galaxy generally does not change significantly on a time frame of just tens of millions of years. So we could expect that it would look quite like this. Now, one other thing we notice is that there's a star in this galaxy down towards the lower right. That star would not be a part of this galaxy itself. That's actually a star within our own galaxy that just happens to be in the same direction. So because we can see how bright that, how distinguished that star is here, we know that it is not a part of this distant galaxy, just one of our own Milky Way stars that happens to be located in the same direction in the sky as this other galaxy. So that was our picture of the day for August the 28th of 2019. It was titled Messier 61 Close Up. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be not a comet. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.